ডাক্তারটা ফেলা বলে দেন
কিছু না
এন্ড টুডে ইজ ওয়ান অফ ইস স্পেশাল কাইন্ড উই হ্যাড দিস প্রোগ্রাম এন্ড মাস মোর দ্যান এনিথিং নট অনলি হ্যাপি আই এম ডিলাইটেড আই ফিল সো ক্লোজ টু দিস গ্রুপ লাইক ইন প্রেজেন্ট গ্রুপ Since 28 years I'm here, I have seen 28, 29 batches going out from here. But as if the fresh students, just few days back, a few years back, they have left the school and I have come back to mother house. So that is a feeling I get from, the heartbeat I get from them. That much of love, that affection, that sincerity towards the school where they have begun their life. And they do remember their class teacher, every nook and corner of the school. And it shows that how much they were connected. They were indebted to the school and connected to the school. Like a small children, how they are related to the mother, always hanging around the apron of mother. The same way I feel, like that, more or less same feeling I got it today. And we are very, very grateful. Every time we conduct medical camp and orientation program for students, but this time the more importance to given to our staff members, and I'm very, very happy about it. And I'm sure they have benefited out of it, and they too are very happy. They too are very happy about it. Thank you. We are ever grateful to Dr. Vinay Dev and his team for taking lot of pain, struggle, sparing their valuable time and energy for their alma mater. And also Mr. Azim Zain, and I have told you that he was following every day, almost every day he was working with us, accompanying us to arrange this camp for us. Also Mr. Ayurikant Patnaik too, especially others I have, I mean, they were, since he is here, almost every day he was coming here to see how things are done. And I am also very grateful to him on behalf of the management and the staff, to the team, Dr. Vinay Dev and his team, as well as the entire batch. All those who are here, I am very, very happy and grateful to all of you. Thank you.
Even we are grateful to NH Rabindranath Tagore International Institute of Cardiac Sciences for their wholehearted support that they have given us. For the medical staff, they have come all the way from Calcutta to help us in this camp. So really we are indebted to the hospital, R&T hospital also.
And the director
Dr. Devi Sethi.
Yes.
We are really grateful to Dr. Devi Sethi.
For sparing their staff.
So it is really a privilege for us to serve our alma mater, that we are really elated to do this service. Whatever bare minimum, this is the minimum we can do for the school. So what we cannot repay the debt which the school has given us. So it is just a small token of love that we have started, and we hope to continue this event annually. That's what we are planning, to get this event done annually, so that the at least one annual medical checkup for the teaching staff, and we'll also try to incorporate the students also of the higher classes for their, at least they should know, because they understand the things better,
day-to-day lifestyle,
how to maintain the lifestyle, how to remain healthy. So
we are proposing it.
Let's see. So hoping for the best.
And
we are really thankful and very, very, very grateful to
No. We are privileged to be here.
You see the support, the acceptance, the encouragement, the thoughtfulness of you to the staff, to the teachers. So that means you take care of your parents too.
Because where we stand now, that it has come from this institution. And I take the privilege to thank my mother. In those days, she has admitted me in this school.
Yes.
So it has given me a very impetus to my life to be here.
There were other schools also.
There were other schools also. But we are
Privileged to get into this school from the very beginning.
Yeah.
That's the foundation laid, this school, the foundation that this school laid, you know, that it is playing a great part in our life.
Yes. Wherever we will be associated with this institution and the other institutions as well. But this is the foundation we have got. And we, I thank you, madam. You are so active and so energetic. So cooperative and very on. We are honored to be here.
I'm grateful and thankful to you.
Our pleasure.
I said so many years apart, but then a kind of contact, a net connection. I mean, a tie is formed. I mean, together. So much of togetherness, kind of closeness.
Yes, belongingness.
Belongingness. Family feeling.
Yeah. Yes, that's correct. We don't feel that we have come to school, we feel that we have come to our home.
I told you, we're just asking like few years back, you are coming. Recent batch, you are gone out like that.
I mean, really, what to say, I should be very thankful and grateful to my school. I mean, always I take care of this thing, this is my school. And whatever I am today is because of the foundation. Generally, I believe if the foundation is strong, I mean, then the house will be strong. I am not speaking of home, I am speaking of a structure here. So if the foundation is strong, then the house is strong. And so also, if the foundation is strong, the home is also strong. So I got both ways, interior and outer. I am extremely grateful to my school. My school, when I say this school, this is a great common school, because I am really blessed to be here. And whatever morals and values I carry in my life, most of them I have really learned from my teachers here, from sisters here. From Mother Superior, who used to counsel us, who used to say so many things. Even, I mean, the trust on God, that also we have been taught by our Mother Superior. So she used to take us to a chapel, he used to hang her, say many things. So also the Father, even, he used to say so many things about the existence of God. That, I mean, from very beginning, from my childhood, I got that, I mean, yeah, there is a supreme power there who guides us. And still today also, I believe the Supreme Power there. I'm really grateful and thankful for that feeling, what was imposed on me by my, and all the discipline, all the, that time, I mean, I was a kid, I could never understand. They punish for every little thing, and I mean, but that, again in my life, when I'm a mother, I'm a wife, or I'm a person working in an organization, that discipline, still I do carry with me, and I'm a very, people sometimes say she's a very strict person, but that also, maybe it can be negative or positive, I don't know, but that also I got from my school, and really I'm ever grateful, thankful to this school of mine, and my friends, and the most, I mean the colorful thing I got in this life are my friends, because of, and in this school I got all my friends, they're still here with me after so many years. We are going to be senior citizens again, two or three years. But still then the bond is there. Someone is in trouble, all of them. Again, over phone, we chat. Though there was pandemic, though there was, we couldn't see each other, but still then, the voice. And that, I mean, that feeling that, say someone you own, that feeling, that though I don't find with the today's kids, that bond, that everything. That also I thank
you
to the school, because I
got
strength from
you. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Actually, that is the foundation that the school has laid. That is the main thing.
We
used to have a moral science subject.
Moral science, actually, it has a lot of moral and values, which we still carry. That is reflected in our society and our homes even. Say someone is sick or someone is in trouble, definitely come up. Because we have been taught in a school to love and to serve. We always think, back of the mind it runs, constantly runs, love and serve, that's all. And so when I'm so fortunate, my friends, I mean, they're part of, say, like my family, part of my life. My organization is a part of my, because it gives me my bread. Mm-hmm. Say, we used to pray, the Father gave us a daily bread. That also the prayer itself, I mean, all of these things, they have made me today what I am today. And so I'm always grateful and thankful to the school. And, whenever the school needs me, if I can do a bit of, I mean, really thankful, and I think that yes, I've done something. I'm really proud to be, I mean, I am happy and I myself is emotionally.
And sometimes I feel sad because when I come here, I just reminisce. Daffodils. When often I in my couch, I see those glancing daffodils. Whenever I talk to my friends, because in life we have a lot of problems even. So when I have a lot of problems, then these people call me up. I don't know, suddenly it goes out. And then I think that, then again the memory of this school, this convent school, it comes back. And always you see this school name itself, the place of settlement. That is the, the heart of the adult. So we all are blessed in that way.
Thanks
a
lot.
We are
so happy to hear. I
said,
I myself
is
happy.
And we are all emotional, actually. And express as well.
This
is heart to heart. We cannot express
heart to express.
But there are many things to say.
It is not from the lips.
It's from the heart. Within the deep.
Yes.
Deep within the heart.
Yes, from the depth of your heart.
Yeah.
Yes, sister. Because the foundation, truly speaking, very honestly, the foundation. Because you see, they were at that time. All my friends, my girls, they all were from, boarding school, from borders. So like Faye, Victoria, Patsy, Beulah, Jenny, all the names, they were staying here. And maybe I was the only Odia, or with some other Odia girls here. And there are a few Bengali girls.
Can you repeat some more names? Because recently one came here, married, and her husband is paralyzed, and he had a stroke. Just spent one day with us. His name is Michael. Sam's name is Michael. But for me, just forgot I have to take it.
Is this Batshi?
I think so.
Is this Batshi?
We also feel like that for you also.
Can't
be Patsy.
No, this is not Patsy.
Can't be Patsy.
I forgot her name. She was in the body.
She's quite young, sir.
She's young. Her husband is already retired. She had a stroke. Twice she had a stroke. And they both brother came Monday and spent time back here with us. I'm very, very happy that here.
Thank you very much, principal of Blessed Sacrament School, high school now. So we are from the school era.
So this is second convent school.
Convent school, yes. So 1966-67, we still remember those days actually, and we have our great Arjaganta Patnaik, who are our leader actually, of those days still, he's still our leader. So all the things which will come from the mind, it will come from him, the innovative things.
Mastermind.
So. And of course, our parents always they have told that this is the school where your foundation was laid for your complete life. So we have remembered the school, and we have been in touch. All our students of our batch, we are mostly in touch. And the people who are not around also, we try to locate them and get them. Asim, I must say, he is actually our fabric glue. So basically, it's much more than binding. It is a fabric glue. He is the glue who actually binds the whole thing. As you can see in the whole camp, he has organized it. We had just conceptualized the whole thing. But he organized everything, made contact with school and taken your help in every matter. And I am very happy that that the school has participated in this manner. And I must say that in my 32 years of cardiology practice, today I think I saw 70 staff of yours, and I found I probably one of them intermittently was smoking. The rest don't smoke at all. That's an amazing thing. Most of them are quite healthy, except for a few here and there. So this is a tribute to how the school is looking after their staff, not only the students. Because if the staff of the school are looked after well, which means, you know, I come back to the workplace. If our workplace is looked after well and led by a person like hers, I think this is a huge tribute to the school. So I am sure that the students of the school as well, we met them 3 years ago, they're a happy bunch basically. They respect her, they're scared of her, and respect her as well. And the same about the staff also. I asked one of them, what happens if you are a smoker? I told, no, madam, sister, you know, she loves us a lot, but if there's anything about smoking, she is very strict. So this is something I think which is an amazing mix. And I'm proud that with all this message we go back to Calcutta. And I'm also proud of the team which has come from NH, Rabindranath Tagore International Institute of Cardiac Sciences. Our founder, chairman Dr. Devi Shetty, under his inspiration, we move around in different parts of the state and also the region and do health camps for awareness purpose basically. We have Mrs. Bandana Mahanti and Mr. Akshay Mahanti, they look after our corporate social responsibility. They do lots of camps all around the state. I think they probably do 300 camps a year. So every day they do those two camps. So we have Mr. Sarajit Sinha. He looks after a lot of districts in West Bengal. So our presence in West Bengal, our hospital's presence and our brand presence in West Bengal is primarily looked after by people like Mr. Sarajit Sinha, who covers a lot of West Bengal. And he is also involved in some of the camps which we do. So he's a great inspiration to us. And Shubhashish, he actually controls my life. I go to the hospital, I sit down and start shouting, and then he controls me. So whatever he does, whenever he says, sir, it's over, I come out of the hospital. So that's the way things are. And he travels with me. He sometimes takes leave from the hospital, his own personal leave, and travels with me. So I'm really, you know, grateful to the whole team which has come. And what to say about Puri? I mean, this is our home, you know. I mean, this is where we have dreamt our all dreams, and this is a homecoming all the time whenever we come to Puri. And I'm sure that we will like to contribute, sister, to the development of the school, the children's mindset. It doesn't have to be that physically we are always around. If you want, virtually, we can always, you know, be on the other end, and you know, through Zoom and all these technologies which we have, I think we should keep in touch. And anytime, any kind of, you know, I mean, I wouldn't say help, but any kind of contribution you require from any of us, I think we'll be more than happy to contribute. Sure. And we'd love to come back, you know, this area, just before we're entering the room, that dreaded area, I think when we were kids, we used to sit down, and we always knew what we have done and why we were called. So, this was our common factor though. Would be our common factor. But I think that's how life has been, and it's been beautiful. I think overall, I think our life has been absolutely beautiful. I think we're very contented, very happy bunch of 60-year-olds now. And we want to live life like this.
Still blooming, guys. How we are knit together.
Our friends who could not join.
Knit together.
They are missing every moment of
two. How we are knit together.
Yes.
I am also encouraged. Yeah. And I mean, blooming with a lot of life. You are blooming with a lot of. I guess children asked, are there people like all of them are parents?
Yes.
But you see, they have seen something which is not seen somewhere else.
So that's why they see how they have immediately they picked up the things.
Yes, yes, absolutely.
And once again, thanks to
each
and everyone. I really, really enjoyed your presence.
Thank you. So, sister, so our favorite quick boy. Started his age from 6 to 16. And this is the right time to celebrate his birthday.
Yes.
Yeah.